Hey y'all, so in this video today, I'm gonna be showing y'all how I styled this wig. So in this video, I plucked the wig and I plucked the hairline, the middle part. I laid the baby hairs and I bleached the part as well. Well, I bleached a lot of the knots. This is a beginner friendly video. So if you wanna see how I styled this wig, just keep watching.
Hey lovelies, and welcome back to my channel. So today, I hope y'all get my washer and dryer going, but I'm washing. Today, I'm gonna be plucking this wig. I bought this wig for my birthday last year in October. And when I ordered it, I didn't look at all the details correctly and I ended up ordering. So I ordered a frontal, but I ordered like a T frontal. So it's not even all lace. This is the only part that's lace. This. So you can only have a middle part. That's it. And some baby hairs. Only a middle part though and some baby hairs. And then on top of that, I don't like the knots at all. These some big black knots right here. Okay, I just wanna show y'all another thing with these T wigs, just in case y'all order one. The front of the wig, you only legit get this much of lace and the rest is just all track. So this is the lace. If you lift that up, that's some lace right there, but the tracks literally start right there. So you only got just enough to do some baby hairs. But I just wanted to show y'all what the T wig is. So basically it's just a middle part, basically a T. Boom, boom, that's all the lace you got. Boom, boom. So this is my sister's wig cap. Don't mind my dead flowers on my head. But this is my sister wig cap. I mean, wig dome head. I'm just about to use this just because I need it. My sister do hair. I'm not the hair doer. I just can do a little one-two. See, a real hairdresser probably wouldn't know how to snap that together. But what I'm about to just do right now is just pluck these fat knots.
Okay, actually before I start plucking the hairline, what I'm gonna do is pull a little bit of hair from the hairline first and then I'm gonna start plucking because I want some baby hair out first and I don't want to pluck too much because like I said, I only got a little bit of hair to work with because this is a T wig. So I don't want to overdo it. So I'm gonna pull a little bit of hair out first from the hairline and then I'm gonna start plucking.
So this is everything from where the tracks start. So the track starts right here and this is where the lace is at. So I took this big chunk and basically split it so I could get a little bit of my baby hairs. So I'm gonna pluck that. I honestly low-key don't wanna pluck too much because it's not too much to pluck. Like what am I about to pluck? I'm just doing a little bit right there. Honestly, I just need to bleach these knots. These knots are dark. That would be the only problem. I just think they really bleach these knots. The knots are like super dark. I don't even know. Yeah, I probably can see it look like little ants.
Right here, I'm just doing the same thing on the other side. Now that I'm looking at this video, I noticed that I pulled a lot of hair from this hairline. Well, on this side. But I'm just doing the same thing on the other side.
So this is all the space that we have to work with for our middle part. The weft of the track start right here. And the other weft of the track is right here. So what I'm about to do is just part right down the middle of this.
So like I said, I'm just parting down the middle. So I'm just parting down the middle of this hair and then I'm about to just straighten it up with the rat tail part of the comb so I can have it even or as even as a part that I can get. And then after that, I'm gonna start plucking the hair.
All right, so now that's the middle part. Now I'm about to just go in and pluck some unwanted hairs. Now this wig is really hard to pluck. I don't know if it's my tweezers that's crappy or what. I really think it's the tweezers.
So it was a tweezer. So now I'm about to just go to the store and get some tweezers and bleach and then I'm gonna come back and finish plucking the hair and then I'm gonna go into bleaching it.
Y'all, I almost got ran over, so I'm gonna just play some music. I don't even feel like thinking right now. I'm just irritated. It was a semi-truck too. I almost ran me off the road. Like it was like 20 cars trying to get his attention so he wouldn't hit me. I'm just irritated. Just song is just Pluck.
Yeah, I was so irritated about a semi truck that I was distracted. I didn't even notice that this was a bad angle, but I'm end up fixing the angle for y'all so y'all can see it a little bit better. But right here, I'm just plucking my middle part. I'm trying to get it as straight as possible. It looked like I'm doing it fast right here, but that's just because I sped the video up and I also got a better angle for y'all. I sped the video up, but you can see like the hair is coming into my tweezers. I'm just parting it down the middle, and as I'm parting it, I'm plucking it. I'm pulling it out real slow, and these knots was hard. Like, they was like some black hard balls, so I really had to tug at these knots. But other wigs that I used to use, or I used, they like not that hard to pluck the wigs. So just make sure you be real careful. But right here, you're starting to see the part kind of come together a little bit. I'm so focused, but I was trying to get them knots. Like, they was so hard to pull. And now I'm just going to the front of my hair. I'm in the front of the hairline, part front of the part, just still plucking. And we go see how it look. She kind of having some technical difficulties right there. I plucked it a little too much, so you kind of see a little bald spot, but I'm gonna get that together. And right here, I'm just plucking the hairline now. My video about to go out.
But I just basically plucked this side too as well a little bit.
Since the video went out, I tried to kind of get this side, but I kind of didn't like the way I plucked this side. But this is how I plucked the hairline. I just was pulling it the same way I did with the middle part. Just was pulling out those hairs, and then I'm going to go to the next step.
Oh, this will take 2 seconds. I'm going to just mix these two together and then apply it on here, and then I'm gonna bleach the knots, and then I'm gonna be back after that and show y'all how it look, and then I'm gonna style it.
Wanted to add a clip video just to show y'all how much bleach I actually use. I real life just only covered up the knots. That was it. I don't got much to work with. So now I washed off the bleach. I let it sit on there for about, I ain't gonna lie, like 45 minutes. I got distracted, and it still really didn't bleach all the knots. These was the hardest knots to ever bleach, but it's okay.
I can't say is it do take bleach though. Did the hell out of that side though, my sheep girl. Some of it bleached a little too much. Some of it bleached like the hair too, so that's kind of why it look not straight no more, cause the hair bleached too. Actually, some of it is supposed to be over.
The part was actually irritating me, so I start plucking it a little bit so I could like it better, because it really wasn't giving what it was supposed to give.
Yeah, let me stop before I do any more damage like that. Yeah, we got the part going on. Be right back. I'm gonna just get my flat iron. I'm waiting on my sister, honestly, because she got the mousse and stuff. So after that, we're gonna be good to go.
All right, so right here, I'm just hot combing the hairline. Well, I'm hot combing the baby hairs down, just so when it's time for me to put the mousse and cut them and everything, they'll be ready to be styled. So I'm just, again, hot combing all of these down, and then I'm gonna start styling like the front of the hairline. Again, the part, it was just irritating me. It wasn't doing what it was supposed to do. So I just, here you're about to just see me just try to straighten it up, because it just really was getting under my skin. It was bothering me. Look at me, I'm focused. All right, so now I'm just adding a little mousse to the hairline, the front of the hair, because I'm about to hot comb that back. So I'm just adding some mousse, so once I do hot combing back, it'll kind of stay a little bit. So now I'm taking a hot comb and I'm just combing it back, because when I'm about to lay my baby hairs, I just want everything to be out the way. And it's kind of the style I'm going for. So this is just like what I'm doing. And it wasn't like staying how I want to stay. So I added some freeze spray, and then you're just about to see me take that hot comb and just hold it there for a minute. That's going to let it stay. Like, it's going to make it stay up there like that. That's kind of the look I was going for. And then I'm going to just do the same thing to the other side. Okay, we getting somewhere. She even showing out. She in the light and everything. We getting somewhere. But right now, I'm just doing a final step. Basically, I'm just drenching it with water, and then I'm just detangling it with a comb, and then I'm gonna detangle it with my fingers as well. I just really wring it out. Like, I wring it out with my fingers from the root of the hair to the bottom, just because I want it to be not like matted up. I want it to be flowing. I don't want it to look, I don't know, I can't really explain it. But after I do that, here's what I'm talking about. I'm just combing it out with my fingers all the way down, just making sure I can go all the way through this hair, just so it can just flow and just look nice and not matted, because this curly hair, it can mat up. And now I'm just adding the mousse to it. I'm adding a lot of product to this hair, because again, this is curly hair and I want it to be moisturized and not look, you know, real dry. So I'm adding a lot of mousse to the hair, and I'm like scrunching it in. Like, I can't really explain, I'm like wringing it in. And right here, I'm just adding more to the ends. So I'm focusing on them ends, because if you can see in the video, the other side of the wig, you can look at those ends, and that's not it. That is just not it. So I'm focusing on them ends, making sure they locked in with a lot of moisture, and I'm just wringing and like scrunching in that product. And right here, I'm about to just add some more water, because like I said, I just want this hair to not look dry. Honestly don't know what this is. It's like a curl definition gel. I just know when I use this, it locks in them curls. I only use a little bit though, and with big sections, just because it can make the hair hard, so I don't want it to be too hard. My friend left this stuff in my house, and every time I got a wig, I use this. I'm just zooming in right here, because when I let the hair go, I just want y'all to see how defined the curls become. Like, I love that gel. Just look at it. So now I'm basically repeating the process, adding it with water. I mean, drenching it with water, and then combing out with my fingers, mousse, and then conditioner. And right here, this is just me focusing on them ends. And here's it all done. This is, it kind of dry. I think I had laid down for like an hour or two. But this is the wig all done. It already got the all the mousse and everything on it. So the next step is them baby hairs. So this is not my strong category. I'm so nervous to do these. But right here, I'm just cutting them as short as I think I should. And now I'm just following what all the Atlanta stylists and tanning them do. I'm just putting that mousse on there. But obviously, I must got the wrong mousse or something, because it, when I did this, it did not work. Like, I tried, and it just, maybe it's because it's on the wig. I'm the dome head. I don't know. So right here, I honestly got some edge tamer. I forgot what brand it was, or edge booster. But I got that, and that still kind of wasn't holding. I'm using my finger to kind of mold it, and then a brush to like swoop it. It just wasn't working for me. But it finally kind of was getting somewhere. And then I kind of figured it was too long. So I got the scissors and I start cutting. Again, I'm just using my fingers to mold it, and then a brush to do the little swoopies. So I'm doing the same thing for the other side. Adding the mousse, I don't know why, it ain't do nothing the first time. Then I'm gonna get a little bit of the edge control again, add the edge control, and then I'm gonna just start swooping it with the comb, and then using my finger to hold that shape and mold. Yeah, I just felt like it was a little too long for my liking, so I'm just taking those scissors and I'm cutting it. So I did the same thing with the rest of the baby hair. I just didn't show it on camera, and I still wasn't satisfied with it. I'm just like, that's too much. So I just again started cutting. I wanted a more so natural hairline, but with this wig, I just felt like I wasn't gonna be able to achieve that. So I mean, a natural baby hair, that's what I wanted. But I actually liked the way it was turning out. I kept looking at the camera trying to see if I liked the way it looked on camera, but I think I really did. So right here again, I'm just cutting it some more, just because I felt like it was just too much hair right there. So after I'm done, I'm molding it again with my finger. And as I'm using that molding little technique, I'm cutting it so it won't like mess up the shape. I'm sorry, somebody called. So right now I'm just taking a hot comb and lifting up that hair like I did originally, just because it kind of went down because I was using all that water and stuff. And now we're done. This is how it's finally looking. Now I'm about to just style it and place it on my head. I wanted to show y'all how I installed the wig, but I didn't. The only thing that I'm about to do different to this wig is just add some foundation on the lace just so those knots can be a little bit more invisible.
Okay, so this is the hair. Honestly, this is 2 days later. The day that I finished the hair, I didn't go out. I didn't go nowhere. I just wanted to do the hair real quick. But I'm just getting ready for work. That's the only reason why my makeup done. It's kind of a little back bushy. It's not like that wet and wavy texture that it was. And I honestly love the way it dried. I like big hair on me. I love curly hair. So I really do like this a lot. The knots, like I said, I add foundation to all my laces. So let's add like a little bit of foundation or a bronzer. I use this bronzer, actually, matter of fact. I use this bronzer. I got it from Ulta in the drug like stores section. But yeah, it's just a wet and well bronzer. I think it was like $4 or $5. But I just put a little bit of that, like took a little makeup brush, just swiped it on there, and I just applied that on. So now you can't see the knots. Like, you don't see the knots at all. My baby hairs is lifting up because, like I said, this is 2 days old. Like, I'm just recording this video, but I'm just being kind of busy. But I do love this hair a lot. I wish I recorded a video of me installing it and stuff, but I didn't. I don't know, y'all. I'm feeling this. But yes, thank y'all for sticking through this whole video. I know this video was long. It was like honestly like 2.5 hours. I chopped it down to, I think by the end of this video it's gonna be like 20 to 22 minutes. I didn't want it to make it too long, so I hope it's not too long for y'all. But if you like this video, give me a like, comment, share, subscribe to my channel. Like I said, I'm be always doing videos revolving around hair, fashion, makeup, all the good stuff, all the jizz, you know, for all the pretty it girls, you know what I'm saying? This our year, our summer.
My video had cut out, but this is the end of the video anyway. I'm sorry if my voice sound a little funny. I just woke up. I'm about to go out to work. But I just really do love how this hair looked. I was going for this look that I seen Jania do, and I feel like I did achieve it. I love it a lot. But if you did stick with me through this entire video, thank you so much. I really appreciate it. Give me a like, comment, share, and subscribe to my page. I will be posting videos more consistently. I'm just trying to get used to editing stuff. It takes a little minute. But again, thank y'all. I really appreciate y'all for sticking with me through this video, and I'll see y'all in the next one. Bye.